Hello viewers and welcome to my channel Museum of Geology. I hope you are doing well. Today my topic is sequence stratigraphy and its application. There are basically non-marine sediments and marine sediments, and combinedly we say the relative distances, as you can see in the figure. The content of the lecture is about the introduction, which contain definition and history, terms related to sequence stratigraphy and application, and conclusion and references. So introduction and definition is the study of strata in terms of sequences, or you can say the study of strata in terms of sequence is the sequence stratigraphy. The sequence part of the name refers to the cyclic sedimentary deposits which are genetically related. The term stratigraphy refers to the geologic knowledge about the processes by which sedimentary deposits form and how those deposits change through time and space on the Earth's surface. Historical background is, so 1788, the James Hutton first recognized unconformities, and he is the father of modern geology today. So the James Hutton is called the father of geology. 1949, Lewis laws used unconformities to define the boundaries of a sequence. Peter Weyl and his Axen team submitted and published the Weyl or Axen curve in 1977, a monograph that represents global geostatic sea level changes based on the seismic and biostratigraphic data. And the terms to be known are geostatic sea level and relative sea level. You can easily see in the both images geostatic sea level and relative sea level. Number one is atmosphere, and number two is global sea level fluctuations. So number two is transgression, regression, and forced regression. You can see in all of these types in the given figure. Number one is transgressive system track, TST. So TST is basically transgressive system track, and number two, MSF, maximum flooding surface, and high strain system tracks. And all of these are our maximum terms has been defined in these pictures and images. Sequence boundaries. The sequence boundaries are deemed the most significant surfaces. Sequence boundaries are defined as unconformities or their correlative conformities, as you can see in the image. Parasequence is a relatively conformable genetically related succession of beds and bed sets bounded by marine flooding surfaces and their correlative surfaces. These are building blocks of sequences. Types of sequence boundaries. Type 1 and type 2, you can see in the images, there are HST and TST and low strain system track. So all of these are, you can see in the image which I have put in the slides. Application of sequence stratigraphy is that it is high resolution stratigraphy and go up to the tune of 0.5 millions of years changes in sedimentation, sedimentary environment, the basin formation, evolution of basin and evolution of the basin, cyclic sedimentation and its controls, and hydrocarbon exploration and geostatic sea level changes and source rock evolution. So all of these are the applications of stratigraphy, or you can say the sequence stratigraphy. Examples: authors have applied sequence stratigraphic study to the beds exposed in Soma Quarry section near Groblington of Rajahmundry AP area to understand the mode of the, or you can say to understand the mode of depositional processes in the basin by integrating litho and biostratigraphic data. This study shows the sequence boundaries TST, MFS and HST deposits got exposed as sea rise and fall. Stratigraphy on Soma Quarry, it is basically the reference of that book. And again, you can see in this picture a case study on an outcrop section, and it is the interpreted well log from Mischief FM author Mehdi Photo and T. Mehdi. It is basically the well-log succession. Conclusion. The conclusion is that sequence stereography is a useful alternative to a lithostereographic approach, which emphasizes similarity of the lithology of rock units rather than time significance. Sequence stereography studies are beset with excellent potential not only for fundamental progress in the geological comprehension, substantively improved resolution, but also in diverse economic geology exploration. Or you can say the economic geology exploration, hydrocarbon, coal, or others. After that, another main important point is that the sequence stratigraphy has developed into a powerful predictive and fishes analysis tool, most suitable for subsurface than outcrop samples. And these are the references of my lecture. So I hope you have enjoyed this lecture. And viewers, if you like this kind of videos, so please subscribe my channel. And I would like to ask my viewers that when I watch or when I see my analytics of my channel, so there are only 2% are subscribers and 98% are non-subscribers. So it is, this point is very disappointment for me. So please subscribe my channel and like this video and also share with your friends. So let's meet in the next video. Thank you.